हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, सो नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू बिगिन विद द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ योर सिलेबस एंड द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज सुश्रुता. सुश्रुता चैप्टर इज अ चैप्टर इज अ लेसन इन विच वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट वेटरनेरियंस, द डॉक्टर्स, दोज हु ट्रीट एनिमल्स एंड टेक केयर ऑफ एनिमल्स. इन दिस लेसन वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न मेजरली अबाउट सुश्रुता एंड हिज टीचिंग्स एंड हिज कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन टूवर्ड्स मेडिकल साइंस. लेट्स सी वॉट सुश्रुता एंड शालिहोत्रा डिड फॉर मेडिकल साइंस. लेसन डॉक्टर चिरंतना मतकरी वॉन्ट्स अस टू फोकस मोर ऑन द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन अ टीचर एंड अ स्टूडेंट. वॉट वॉज द रिलेशन बिटवीन अ टीचर एंड अ स्टूडेंट ड्यूरिंग दैट टाइम? इट वॉज अ वेरी ऑनेस्ट, हार्ड वर्किंग एंड सिंसियर रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन सुश्रुता एंड शालिहोत्रा. ऑल्सो इट वॉज द सेम एंड दे डिड इट विथ फुल कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन. दे डिड इट विथ फुल ऑनेस्टी, विथ फुल जस्टिस. महर्षि सुश्रुत, father of plastic surgery, a genius who has been glowingly recognized in the annals of medical science. Born to sage Vishwamitra, Acharya Sushrut details the first ever surgery procedures in Sushrut Samhita. Sushrut Samhita, a unique encyclopedia of surgery, was written by Maharishi Sushrut. He is venerated as the father of plastic surgery and the science of anesthesia. Students, just try to imagine, during those days it was so difficult to access a surgery without proper technology, without proper lights, without proper medicines, without proper tools, without proper knowledge. But still Maharishi Sushruta and his teachers had done a very genius work, an excellent work, an excellent contribution towards medical surgery. They had so much of knowledge regarding the particular animal. They studied so well that today also we take the reference of their surgeries. When surgery was its infancy means at a very early stage in Europe, Sushrut was performing rhinoplasty, that is restoration of damaged nose. Just imagine, during those days when it was just the beginning of learning what is surgery in Europe, in India Sushrut was already performing a plastic surgery, that is restoring the damaged nose and other challenging operations. In Sushrut Samhita he prescribed treatment for 12 types of fractures and 6 type of dislocation. His details on human embryology is a small baby child, so embryo means a baby, so his details on human baby are simply amazing, and he studied those during that age. Sushrut used 125 types of surgical instruments including scalpels, lancets, needles, catheters, rectal speculums, mostly designed from the jaws of animals and birds. He has also described a number of stitching methods in his book. So in this book we can see that Sushrut was so intelligent, he was so genius, that out of the animal jaws, out of the things, out of the tools which were available near him, surrounding near him, he made his own instruments for learning the surgery. And so he was such a good veterinarian. He cared for his animals, he cared for living being. And in the second part we are going to see how veterinarian medicines came into existence, how the expansion of this type of doctory, how this type of medicine medical treatment came into existence and forward in India and other parts of countries. So now let's see what we are going to learn in today's lesson. Today's lesson, that is Sushruta, a peep into past, is going to be divided in two parts. In the first part, we are going to see the story between the teacher Shalihotra and his student Sushruta. Sushruta, a peep into the past. Part 1. Sushruta was indeed a bright student of veterinary medicine. His teacher Shalihotra once decided to test him. He asked Shalihotra what all would he need to perform a surgery on a wonderful horse. Sushruta very quickly listed down all the instruments and medicines that would be needed. Three things are missing, Shalihotra said. Confused, Sushruta looked at him. I will give you a week to find them, Shalihotra consoled. Curious to find out what those three things were, Sushruta observed his teacher carefully for the next 1 week. Before operating the horse, Shalihotra observed every part of the horse. And then Sushruta found out the first missing thing. A good veterinarian should have an eagle's eye. What was the first thing which Shruta find out? It was an eagle's eye. A good veterinarian should always have eagle's eye to look each and every body part of the animal which he is treating. Then Shalihotra treated the animal as if it was his own, balancing science and compassion equally, and lo, Shushruta found his second rule. A good veterinarian should have a lion's heart. Now looking at the patient, the doctor should not feel that I don't have any relationship with him, I should not treat him well. No, he should have a lion's heart. He should think that as a human being, this person is mine, I am going to treat him. So a good veterinarian should have eagle's eye and also have lion's heart. Shalihotra helped the horse recover after the surgery. Shushruta came to know that a good veterinarian should have a mother's touch too. After giving the treatment, the doctor should not leave the patient just like that. That just go home now, it is okay. No, he should take care. He should keep regular follow-ups to ask the patient whether he is okay or not. He should take proper care of the patient, right? So he has understood that the third rule was to have the mother's touch, to take care of the patient because he is in pain, he is in trouble, he is suffering through something, right? So now Shushruta could find out all the three things. A good veterinarian should have eagle's eye to look at the patient properly. A good veterinarian should have lion's heart to take care of the patient, to look after him properly, to think as if he is of his own, and he should have mother's touch, a feeling of warmth, a feeling that this, you are mine, I'm going to take care of you, you are going to get well, right? So now Shushruta has found out all the three things. Later in his life, Shushruta wrote a book on surgery. Part 2. A tradition of veterinary therapy developed very early in India, and this has survived to the present time. Based on the Ayurveda, Indian veterinary medicine is known for its specialized literature, which provides information on an ancient methods of preventing and treating disease of animals. Some of these treatments outside India are still practiced today. The oldest existing veterinary text from India is treatise entitled as Ashvayurveda Siddhanta, a complete Ayurvedic system for horses. Attributed to Shalihotra around 2350 BCE. See how old it is. The founder of veterinary medicine. Who is the founder of veterinary medicine? Shalihotra. Subsequently, various treatises on horses and disease of horses were composed. Nakula, one of the five Pandavas, was horse specialist himself. Among the best known works of animal literature is Aswa Chikitsa, Therapeutics of Horses, written by Nakula. Students, I hope you remember who are five Pandavas, Arjuna, Bhim, Nakula, right? So among those, Nakul was very famous for horse treatment. He was specialized. He even wrote various books for the horses, and he opened Aswa Chikitsa, that is an therapeutics for horses. Shushrut, a disciple means a student of Shalihotra, wrote on animal surgery. This made people aware of surgical methods, dressing of wounds, bandaging of fractures, etc. Later, during the reign of Chandragupta Maurya, around 300 BC, veterinarians started accompanying armies to treat horses, elephants, as well as cattle. So, along with the armies, even these veterinarian doctors would go on the battlefield so that the animals could be treated properly. The great Emperor Ashoka erected the first known veterinarian hospital of the world. He arranged cultivation of herbal medicines for men and animals in his empire and adjoining kingdoms. Giving the animals general tonics and stimulants was practiced in order to ensure good mental and physical health. Because animals were used on a very large scale during those ages. Even in wars, they used to go on elephants, horses were used. During cultivation, bullocks were used. Then there were so many animals which were used during that age at a large scale. So animals were an important part of living during olden times. So King Emperor Akbar took initiative to build a veterinarian hospital. In the whole world, it was the only hospital built during that time. And even he arranged cultivation of herbal medicines for men and animals, those who were working in his empire and surrounding kingdoms. Prevention of occurrence of disease was also given importance. Cleanliness of animals, maintenance of stalls and stables, quality of food, disadvantage of overfeeding were looked after. So see, so many practices were seen over at that time also. Utilization of animals by products was also done wisely by our ancestors. Conversion of milk into butter, ghee, curd, khoya, etc. was common practice during that time and it's done even today. Chicken was utilized for its meat while sheep was used for its wool. Although India has always had an immense knowledge in the field of veterinary science, it is not chosen as a career by many due to the lack of awareness. Being an agriculture-based country, today India needs more veterinarians who empathize with animals and give them the 100% of the profession. Means we have seen that people choose to have many types of doctories, but very few number of people, students have been opted for the veterinary science. Even if the knowledge has been with us for such a long time, from our ancestors, it is so old, the knowledge is so old. Still, many people choose to select other doctories over veterinary science. So it is important that this can be a career option and we take this as this seriously, because our country, our world still needs doctors who take care of all the living beings which are around us, including animals. So animals are also as important as living beings, and we should give importance to the career of veterinary science also. So I hope you have understood the chapter and understood what message Dr. Chirantana Matkari wanted to give us all. She wanted us to think about animals as living beings and treat them well, take care of them, right? And in this lesson we also learn that student and teacher relationship should always be in such a way that full contribution should be given from the teacher's side as well as from the student's side. Only then the knowledge will be gained. Students, see how well Sushruta started observing his teacher, and he saw that these all principles are used by his own teacher, and so he also used three principles which were very important to treat any animal: to have an eagle's eye, to have a lion's heart, and a mother's touch. So in this way, I would like to tell you all that always observe good qualities of your parents, of your teachers, of your siblings, of your friends, and utilize them in your own life. Thank you.